if anybody out there has tried any of these unethical life hacks, definitely hit us up at 410-338-1098. I'm thinking to myself, who would do this? What rude person would try and pull some of these things off? They're on TikTok. There's a feed dedicated to unethical things that you can do to make your life easier. Like, oh, here's one. When a coworker calls in sick to work, you do the same thing a couple, 3 days later. Your boss will think it's something that's going around and may even do the same thing. It's called the fake flu. It makes a lot of sense.
Funny.
I would never think to do that, though.
I am now.
Listen to you, yeah.
Oh, my knee hurts. I guess I caught it from Kirk.
Can't really do that.
Oh.
My knee is not contagious, but yeah.
Marianne, we've told you.
Somebody starts coughing a little bit.
Yeah.
Let's say you get off at 5. You start that thing up around 1 o'clock in the afternoon. So by the end of the day, everybody knows you're sick.
Yeah, yeah.
And then
not bad.
You can pull it the next day and say, I must have gotten it from Marianne. Hey, if the person in front of you on their flight reclines their seat, I never do this, turn the air blower on full blast and point it directly at their head. I guess you're going to get a little more leg room now, aren't you?
I don't care if people lean back in front of me, so I'm not going to do that.
Some people lose their mind.
I know.
And I think...
But you're allowed.
You only get 2 inches.
It helps.
I never go to that. But everybody's got their own style.
Yeah, I do it as soon as the plane is in the air. That's when I recline.
I'd see your blonde hair going...
Woo.
Blow it into breeze. If you've got a single roommate that's a total slob, this hack says, create a fake profile on an app that they're using and then match with them. Suggest you come over for a date and see how fast they clean the place up. That's a lot of work.
That is so much work. I thought you were going to be like, and then have them murdered
by
this date. Yeah, that's ridiculous.
I wouldn't do that. That's too much to go through.
Yeah. Come on.
These are unethical life hacks that people... They're
unusable.
Rude as hell. Right. It says, and I've seen this one done before, when you don't really want to call somebody, but you want to make it look like you tried.
But
you know this
smell.
One. Well, you put your phone in airplane mode, then make the call, and it'll show the call being made, but it won't go through. So I guess you have to show your phone. Look, dude, I tried you.
I didn't know that. I used to do the thing where you call, and then you have somebody else call, so you get the voicemail or something like that.
So you had your own hack that you weren't.
It requires a friend.
Yeah, it does. Here's a good one. Squash a memory foam pillow and fart on it while it expands out. It'll suck in the fart particles, and
really?
They're going to get released when the next person uses the pillow.
Shut the front door.
I know.
I'm going to go fart in a pillow tonight.
It's got to be memory foam.
I don't have that.
Squash a memory foam pillow.
That'll give somebody an eye infection.
Ew.
Yeah.
You got fart eye.
Yeah.
How about this one? So many guys have done this one at 410-338-1098. Use a pawn shop to avoid paying for an expensive wedding ring. Tell your girl it belonged to your grandma. Make it more sentimental.
So you go get a... old right
just some old
yeah,
ring
that's fine that's not unethical
you've got to
well,
like it though
you can't lie I don't
why
like
can't
lying
you? Well the guy says this used to be my grandmother's
why
I want
just
you to have
go
it.
Buy it from pawn shop
well you buy it from the pawn shop and then you label it as grandma's ring it gives you a little more street cred as far as sentimentality and let's see if you don't want to talk to your rideshare driver, leave a message and pick up notes that says you're deaf. Oh, God.
No, again, that's too much work.
That's going. And
then you have to, like, go through with it.
And you might want to sign a little bit when you're getting out. And how about you say you're deaf on the ride and then your phone rings like, no, man, I'm on
exactly.
the ride.
Exactly. You can't do that. You now have to act hearing impaired or whatever you're supposed to say.
And Costco. You can get around your membership to Costco with a gift card. Just get what you need, pay for the rest with a debit card, no membership required. I know there's ways to get around.
I'm sorry, what do you do? When you walk in, don't they check your ID?
I don't think they get to you until you're checking out.
Oh, okay. And then how do you get the gift card?
It says you can get around a membership to Costco with a gift card. Just get what you need. So let's say you have a gift card for $20 and you buy $30 worth of stuff for $40. You pay with that gift card, and then you pay for the rest of the stuff with your debit card.
Where'd you
card.
Get the gift card?
Somebody gave it to
like
you?
Like a Costco gift card?
Either that or Visa. a Visa gift card. You ever seen those?
Okay, I don't know if I get it, but that's fine. I'm not going to Costco.
I don't go to Costco or Walmart. I go to Walmart, but not Sam's Club.
Yeah,
and BJ's. These are tricks to use at one of those big places like that.
Write them down.